I am Jennifer Foxworthy, and I am a domestic violence thriver. I came from a broken place. As a young girl, I was looking for love and acceptance in the wrong places, and I didn't feel pretty. My self-esteem was low, and I didn't know my worth. I was punched, slapped, and called names. I was lied to and missed all the warning signs. But today, I am happily married to my loving husband, Tom. I am a mother, an author, a motivational speaker, an entrepreneur, and I am your host of Living Unshackled on Purpose. Hi, welcome to Living Unshackled on Purpose. I am your host, Jennifer Foxworthy. I am excited about this episode. We are talking about human trafficking awareness. Many people don't know what that is and why they should care. But I have an amazing guest with me today. Her name is Jennifer Edwards. She's the director of the Calvert County Crisis Intervention Center and Safe Harbor. And she is here today to educate us, to empower us, and to equip us. Welcome to Living Unshackled on Purpose, Jennifer.
Thank you so much. Good to see you again.
Oh my goodness, it's been amazing. It's been a while since we've done an interview together.
Indeed.
So today we're talking about human trafficking awareness. January is the month of recognition. Jennifer, from what I understand, when I talk to people about human trafficking awareness, they don't know what it is. Can you please explain?
Certainly. Human trafficking is, in effect, a modern day slavery. It can encompass many different aspects, which can be very difficult to see and recognize. There is labor trafficking, mm-hmm. such as being extraordinarily underpaid or not paid at all, forced into a type of indentured servitude. Mm-hmm. And there is, of course, sex trafficking, which affects the most vulnerable of all of our citizens, not only in Maryland, but in the country and around the world as well.
My goodness. It just blows my mind. The evil that people can use others for such a horrible epidemic.
It is a horrible epidemic, Jen. In 1 year alone, over 25 million individuals around the world are human trafficked in one form or another, be it labor or sex trafficking. And it is a huge financial enterprise for those traffickers. So when it comes to sex trafficking, my agency deals primarily with domestic violence, sexual assault, trauma. So we deal helping people a lot with the sex trafficking aspect of things. And one individual can earn a human trafficker about $200,000 a year.
My word.
The average lifespan of an individual, and we're talking the most highly prized individuals that are targeted for sex trafficking, are children between 12 and 14 years of age. So a 12 to 14 year old, once they are drawn into the life, can bring about $200,000 a year. Unfortunately, they can only last about 7 years due to drug abuse, due to the sexual violence, due to a plethora of other things, not being able to eat, whatever abuses their traffickers perpetuate upon them. So if you multiply $200,000 a year by that 7 year mark with most children who are human trafficked, we're talking one individual could bring a trafficker $1,400,000 worth of services.
No wonder it's such a lucrative, heinous business. I wanted to, you know, it's like we hear about drug trafficking, but human trafficking, I guess it's, they can be in a vehicle, and if they get pulled over by police,
Absolutely.
They don't know, yeah.
There are many misconceptions about human trafficking, particularly because we hear the word trafficking, so we feel that that must mean an individual is mobile, being moved from one place to another. Mm-hmm. When in reality, many are trafficked right out of their home or their schools, wow, their community centers, other places like that. And the other thing is these traffickers, these evil individuals, are so smart in the way that they would draw a 12 to 14-year-old into their grip.
Tell me about that.
There's many different types of ways that these traffickers start to bring people in. And the most common way is by finding those who are suffering from poverty or are an outcast at school, something like that, and they become a boyfriend type of figure. Ah. Now, I will make a quick caveat that not all human traffickers are males. There are, of course, women human traffickers as well, but many times those children become a girlfriend to this pimp, for lack of a better term. He will buy them things, he will spend money on them.
Kind of like a Romeo.
Absolutely, Romeo and pimp. That is one of the forms of human traffickers. They're called a Romeo pimp. Mm. And it works, and that individual feels recognized, they feel special, they feel part of something, they feel loved.
Right.
And so once that pimp has that trafficking victim under their spell, he will then, or she will then, kind of flip the script on them and could become what we refer to as a guerrilla trafficker. Mm. Now, if I'm your trafficker and I have gone through the Romeo stage with you, Jen, now I'm going to turn it and I'm going to not feed you. I'm going to keep you from eating. I'm going to keep you from sleeping. I'm going to keep you from interacting with loved ones. And if you go against what I say, I will beat you.
My goodness. Now, Jennifer, is this only happening in the cities?
Absolutely not. Absolutely not. As a matter of fact, Maryland itself is considered a hotspot for human trafficking.
Oh, wow.
It is one of the biggest hotspots that our country has right now. And if you think about it, we have the ocean, we have our rivers and our tributaries in the Chesapeake Bay right there, so traffickers can bring their victims in via water. Mm-hmm. We have BWI International, Reagan, we have Dulles, so they can be flown into sporting events or political events or other gatherings where many individuals meet. And then we have the I-95 corridor, which runs straight through Maryland, like it does many other states. So it makes quite easy for traffickers to bring their victims in and do their business and get their victims quickly out again before they're recognized.
My word. I bet with the Super Bowl coming up, you got MGM's, the casinos.
Absolutely.
Oh, good gracious.
So there will be... If you know where to look, if you know how to see some of the signs, there will be an abundance of traffic victims, not only sexually trafficked, but potentially labor traffic victims as well, that will be made available at these big arena type events, especially with the Super Bowl coming up. Not to mention we have an election year coming up next year
as well. That is very true. Now you mentioned a key word, the signs. For those who are watching this video, what if they suspect someone being trafficked or a trafficker, would they look for? What are some of the signs?
That's a good question, Jen. And the signs can be extremely subtle. So you may see things like, and we're talking primarily children, although it's not exclusive to children, the 12 to 14-year-olds. One day they may have a wonderfully priced wardrobe. Suddenly they have jewelry, or they are extremely busy after school hours, or perhaps you cannot find them on the weekends because they're working. And so you will see subtle changes. You may have someone who was extremely withdrawn, and then suddenly they're more open and they're inviting girlfriends or guys they may know to certain parties to come hang out with these cool people I've just met. And so each trafficking victim could then, and sometimes they are forced to bring in those newer, fresher victims to become part of this.
My goodness. Tattoos can also be an outward, an external sign that someone's being trafficked. Certain looking tattoos, right?
Absolutely. And one could do a quick search, a quick Google search for images of human trafficking. And quite often you will see many different type of tattoo markings from the pimp's name, which the Romeo pimp will say, put my name on you because we're now boyfriend and girlfriend. So that victim will, of course, want to please him. We have seen the barcodes, like you often see on food products or anything that the cashiers use at checkouts, will often be placed on the back of the neck, or crowns or different things. Traffickers, you must remember, are very ingenious, and so they are always changing their tactics to stay away from law enforcement.
Wow, this has been so eye-opening. What can someone who suspects trafficking happening, what resources in Maryland, in Calvert County, locally, can they get to?
Absolutely. Right now, the governor's office of crime control and prevention, via Larry Hogan, has a human trafficking task force that certainly you can go on that website and glean more valuable information. What are the signs to look for? What can you do to help out? There is a national human trafficking hotline, and I will provide you with the number for that. In Maryland, we have wonderful networks. One of them is the Maryland Network Against Domestic Violence. They can provide information on human trafficking, as well as MCASA, which is the Maryland Coalition Against Sexual Assault. And the other thing that I'd like to tell you about is in the state of Maryland, we have 17 counties. Each county is required to have a rape crisis center.
Okay.
And these are centers that operate primarily, most of them, via grant funding.
Okay.
And there are laws in place that we do not have to charge our survivors for the therapeutic services they need.
That's important.
Confidentiality is the most important thing when we work with our survivors. So anyone can look up what is a rape crisis center in my county, and they will be able to see what center is closest to them, and they can then call for information and for confidential services.
Jennifer, you have been a wealth of information. We are passionate about getting this awareness out to people. As we wrap up, what do you want people to know? Talk directly to them briefly. Why should they care? How, you know, what is it that you want them to know and to get this driven home?
Absolutely. What I'd like to say is that I truly believe in my heart, human trafficking in all of its forms is modern day slavery. There are those of us in this world who are still bound by the chains of slavery. It knows no age, no gender, no race. It affects us all. And the most fearful for me is that it affects our children, not just mine individually or yours individually, but our children in our communities. Please educate yourself. Begin to know the signs. If you see a child who has been bullied or is isolated, that is the perfect target for these pimps and traffickers to come in and abuse this child. It affects each and every one of us. We are all here to try to make things better, and one way to do that is to recognize the children, our children, all of ours. Please learn the signs. And if you have any questions, or if you believe you yourself or someone you care about might be at risk or in danger of being trafficked, please reach out to your local rape crisis center. Please call Crisis Intervention Center. We will help you anytime. Our phone number is 410-535-1121, and we will be able to lead you to specific resources in your area. Thank you all so much.
Well, there you have it. Jennifer, thank you so much for being on Living Unshackled on Purpose. This is a platform under Unstoppable You Ministries, and we are in the trenches, filling in the gaps, providing supportive resources for those affected by domestic violence, human trafficking, and homelessness. And many people don't realize that many people are checking the box on each one of those.
Yes.
So January, Human Trafficking Awareness Month, educate yourself, empower yourself, equip yourself, make a difference. This is a horrible epidemic. It's a multi-billion dollar industry in the United States. And Jennifer has provided us such insight. If you have any questions about this episode or how to contact Jennifer Edwards, we're going to have her information in this episode. But this is Unstoppable You Ministries. This is Living Unshackled on Purpose. I am your host, Jennifer Foxworthy.